Dear all, welcome to this new tutorial dedicated to Adobe Premiere Pro, one of the best video editors you can use to realize your own videos by adding nice effects, transitions, and color adjustments. In just 12 minutes, you're going to see everything you need to learn to start using it straight away. Premiere Pro comes with the Creative Cloud Bundle, and it is available for both Windows and Mac OS with a proper subscription plan. When you open Premiere, the home screen page opens, showing several options to start off. You can pick any latest project made. Go to Open Project on the left to browse for any other project, or click on New Project to start with a new one by setting Name, Destination Folder, and Further Video and Audio options at the bottom. The new project opens on the main interface, made by several panels that may change according to the workspace you select from the top. In this tutorial, we will use the editing one only, but you can always reopen any missing panel from the Window tab. Before going on, let's understand the main structure of any Premiere Pro project. Each project is made by several sequences, such as independent pieces of video created by combining pictures, videos, and audio files together within a timeline view made of tracks in time. When starting a new project, you won't have any sequence, so use Control or Command and N to make a new one. On the left, select the right video template to use, or switch to Settings above to use your own options. Select Custom on Editing Mode to apply your own frame rate, frame size, color code, sample rate, and so on. Consider that you will work with these sequence properties through the whole video editing process. Once the sequence is in place, you can import files by dragging and dropping these to the timeline tracks from any folder or the main media browser panel on the left. Pictures and videos are collected inside video tracks with a V letter as blocks in pink and blue color, respectively, whereas sound files inside audio tracks with an A letter as blocks in green color. You can use your mouse wheel to move through time and use it with Alt or the Option key to zoom in and out around your mouse cursor. You can find all your imported files and created sequences inside the project panel on the left. To get a quick preview of your sequence in progress, you can use the program panel on top, showing the frame under the blue timeline playhead. Click and drag on the timeline to move it and check specific frames in time, or use the player buttons to play back all in real time smoothly. If you get a laggy preview, you may need to lower its quality with playback resolution, or reduce its size by going to Sequence, Sequence Settings, Video Preview. Just pay attention to keep the same aspect ratio between width and height size of your sequence. As you import clips, some of these may appear zoomed in, cut, or with annoying black bars if these do not match the sequence size and aspect ratio. To resolve black bars, open the project panel, right-click on the sequence, and go to Auto Frame Sequence, selecting the correct aspect ratio to keep. A new sequence will be created with all the clips zoomed in enough. You may need to add other clips if these are missing, and correct others if they are too much enlarged. We will see how to adjust these later in this video. Let's see how to edit these clips. Enable the selection tool on the left and click on any clip to select it and drag it to move it in time or in another track. Video frames and audio are always moved together unless you right-click on these and go to Unlink to make them independent. If clips overlap, the preview shows the clip on the top video track in front of all the others in lower positions. Click and drag any clip edge to adjust its duration. This cuts content from videos and audio files to make these shorter in time. To extend and shorten these in time without cutting content, you can change their playback rate with the Rate Stretch tool. A shorter clip is played faster, over 100%. And an extended clip is played slower, below 100%. whereas enable the Razor tool and click on the clip to split it. You can cut, copy, and paste any clip by selecting it with the Selection tool and right-clicking on it. Choose Clear to remove any clip definitely. Make sure to use Control and Command and Z to undo if you make any mistake. You can also open the History panel to go backwards in the list. On the left, you get several options for each track. The I button hides and shows content from the video track. Use M, Mute, and S, Solo buttons to mute or solo the audio track. And the Record button allows to record from any microphone directly on the audio track. You can adjust the recording source and options with Edit, Preferences, Audio Hardware. Enable the Lock button to prevent modifications on any track and adjust the whole sequence volume with the mix track at the bottom. Make sure to avoid red volume levels or you risk to get distortion in output. To add or remove tracks, right-click on any vacant part on the left. You can adjust all the properties of any clip by selecting it and opening the Effect Controls panel. Here, click and drag to change values. Click on the FX button to disable or enable any property modification, and use the Reset button to revert these to their original value. Depending on the kind of clip selected, you get video and audio options. On images and videos, you can adjust position and size with scale, especially if the clip is bigger than the preview or is partially cut. Rotate the clip with rotation and add transparency with opacity. On audio, you can set the volume level and balance the stereo channels. From the effects panel, you can browse for loads of video and audio effects that you can apply by dragging and dropping these on any clip. These effects get listed within the effects controls panel, where you can edit their properties while checking the preview. You can remove any effect. Just right-click on it and go to Clear. You can also apply advanced corrections to colors and audio with several panels on the right. Open Lumetri Color to adjust brightness, exposure, contrast, and color intensity with sidebars, color wheels, and color curves. Whereas with Essential Sound, select the kind of source you have selected and apply audio ducking, reverb, and audio adjustment. We won't see these panels in detail in this quick beginner tutorial. From the Effects panel, you can also add video and audio transitions by dragging and dropping these on any clip edge or between two adjacent clips. These allow to change the video content with smooth and nice effects. Click on the transition name to select it and drag its edges to change its extension. The longer it is, the slower the transition effect is. You can also open the effects controls to adjust its properties and right-click on it and go to Clear to remove it definitely. With Premiere, you can also drop vector drawings and pieces of text. Enable the rectangle and the ellipse tool and click and drag on the preview to drop regular shapes. Whereas use the pen tool to make your own drawings, dropping straight sides as you click on the preview and custom curves when you click and drag, following the Bezier technique with tangent handles. In addition, enable any text tool to drop horizontal or vertical text. Click and drag on the preview to define a text contour and type within it. All these shapes and titles are collected within a pink clip that can be moved and edited just like other clips. You can also enable the Selection tool to move, scale, and rotate these objects within the preview. Whereas open Effects Controls to adjust fill and stroke appearance. and also the text font, style, size, distribution, and color. You can also use the Essential Graphics panel to adjust all these properties as well, all collected under Edit. You can switch to Browse to find ready templates to add motion titles, lower thirds, and credits. To save your project, go to File, Save As. This saves your project with all its sequences and clips within a .prp ROJ format in order to reopen and edit it anytime. Whereas to render and export your project into a video, select the right sequence and go to File, Export, Media. On the left, go to Source to crop the video as you need and trim it by dragging the white markers placed at the bottom. On the right, select the video format and the preset to use. You can also customize video and audio properties at the bottom, changing the video size, aspect ratio, frame rate, audio codec, and sample rate. Enable the check mark on the right to be sure to match the original source files. Click on Output Name to set video name and where to save it. Then go to Export to render it. Thank you very much for watching. Make sure to check out our YouTube channel and our website for more amazing and outstanding free guides.